So any procedure that we could write recursively, we can also write without using a recursive definition. And I want to show you another way that we might have defined is palindrome. So here we're doing this with a for loop, and we're looping using the variable I and the range from 0 to the length of S divided by 2. So that's going through halfway of S. And inside the loop, we have an if test that checks if the character at position I is different from the character at position negative I plus 1. So that's going to be counting from the back of the string I positions away. If those are different, then we found a mismatch and we return false. If they're not different, we're going to keep going through the loop. Once we get to the end of the loop without finding any differences, we know it's a palindrome and we return true. So this is also another way we could define is palindrome. I think this is more complicated to understand and harder to get right. It took me 3 tries before this code worked correctly, whereas the recursive definition I could get right the first time. If we wanted to test very long palindromes, this would be much more efficient than the code that we had with the recursive definition. And there are a couple of reasons for that. One is that the recursive definition keeps making new strings. Every time we do the recursive call, we have to create a new string, and that's pretty expensive. Another reason is that the recursive calls themselves are fairly expensive. And there are languages that make recursive calls fairly cheap. Python is not one of them, and Python is fairly expensive to do a recursive call. So for most procedures, the recursive way is often the most elegant and the easiest way to get correct. If we're really worried about performance and we need procedures to work on really large inputs, we're often better off trying to find a non-recursive way of defining that procedure.